South Africa escaped with the smallest of margin wins when their first meeting between South Africa and Argentina last weekend. But the tables have been turned and we make our way to Argentina for the second meeting between these two nations, where the home advantage could turn that small difference around to a famous victory for the Argentinians. Will it happen? Will they have enough in the tank? We will find out over the next 18 minutes as Argentina at home hosting the Springboks in the Rugby Championship. Hello everyone and welcome along to Cornflakes Crib, your home of Rugby Challenge 3 and the Rugby Championship Series. We were in the fourth match of the competition in our second meeting between Argentina and South Africa. The Argentinian side has undergone no changes from the team that met the Springboks last weekend, and they'll be hoping that this team, with the help of this home crowd, could be the difference that sees them get that little bit extra and a little bit more over the line and take a famous victory against one of the world's best. They'll be looking for their key man, the likes of Creevy and this forward pack, to lead this team forward as they do so well, and the excitement machines in the back line looking more and more threatening as the weeks go by. South Africa, on the other hand, have made just the one change, with Vincent Koch coming into the front row to partner Mtoawera and Strauss. Other than that, they are unchanged as well. Warren Whiteley, the hero from the opening round of the competition, and they'll be hoping to see more of that leadership from the big number eight. But it's a hostile environment for the visiting sides here in Argentina, and it's going to be a tough ask for the side to come out on top. But as the saying goes, if you want to be the best team in the world, you have to beat everyone in every stadium. Can they do it here today? Argentina are a team that love confidence, and if they get their tails up here with this crowd at their back, they could be one tough team to stop. We're all set to get underway here. Argentina, the home team, kicking off so big, so massive for the side to be playing under their home crowd. And it will be, of course, Nicolas Sanchez, who will do the opening act of the match. He turns to his right and he hits this high looking for Lavanini, but only gets him to Herrera. And Creevy pulls him down, and Argentina quickly over the top of him, turning the ball over. Away it goes to Issa, the number eight, storming through the heart of the defence, getting into the 22. South Africa quickly on the back foot, trying desperately to hang on to the ball. Comes back now to Guzman, away to Herrera, away to Cordero, and that's the start that the Argentinians would have wanted. The Pumas hit the lead. It's 5-0. Wow, what a pass over the top that found Santiago Cordero, and he is the absolute finisher in the side. Creevy spots it, one out he goes, and it's his front row partner Herrera who delivers a point perfect pass to Cordero on the outside of three defenders, would you believe? The two front rowers, look at this, 3-on-2, over the top, and Torreira, he cannot even keep a grasp on Cordero as he slides in for the opener. That's the start Argentina wanted. Exactly what the doctor ordered. And to be fair, exactly what South Africa didn't want, because confidence is what breeds success in teams like Argentina. This crowd will be running behind them, and Sanchez is on top of his game, a world-class goal kicker these days, and he puts Argentina up 7-0. Just 6 minutes gone, unlikely scene in the last game. New Zealand and Australia, we've got points in the first half, and South Africa have hardly even touched the ball. Alton Yancey's gets this off again, and he kicks it away for Matera, who pulls it in. Landajo goes short to Hernandez, cuts one or two out to Orlando, and Orlando slides away past Delaney. Cordero gets the pass, and Santiago Cordero gets away just, but he's held over. That's the try saver from Brian Habana. Wow, the lack of experience, some may say, there on Santiago Cordero's part. He didn't put the ball down at first opportunity. And that gave a chance for Brian Habana to pull him down over the dead ball line. Now they attack again. Matera, this time left side. Orlando throws out the back. Montero this time, the Guzman. Herrera does well. Creevy. Oh, straight to the middle. Creevy's taken very high. And it is the Springboks captain, Arjan Strauss, the guilty party. The two hookers going at it. And Argentina happy to slow this one down and have a look at some 3 points through their sharpshooter, Nicolas Sanchez. Definitely within his range here. Sanchez tees off. Oh, a dreadful kick from Sanchez. It's dribbled into the 22 of South Africa. Release. And it's pulled in from Ludiega. Well, that was a gimme 3 points there. What is going on with Sanchez?
Advantage.
Advantage. Is that a forward pass around the breakdown? I think it is. Unbelievable to see. Oh, that's a big error from Faf de Klerk.
Find.
Well, to see a miss Six. Of that shot by Sanchez is just unthinkable. Landajo, now he goes to Sanchez, who's going to have another go at it. This time, no mistake. Argentina happy to sit back and take the 3 points on offer. They do get their three and they're up 10-0. Quickly back to Sanchez, sat deep and slots it from right in front. No mistake, no error. It's 10-0 Argentina over South Africa. Well, it should have been here a couple of minutes ago, but unbelievably missed penalty. Herrera, Lavanini, Issa, they quickly distributed it wide. And a Sanchez looks for support, doesn't get the man he wanted. Creevy was right there, Release. But Combrink's come away with it. And he saved the blushing faces of South Africa for now. Strauss has slipped it in, and Faf de Klerk's the one who pulls it to ground for South Africa. Here is Lowe. Oh, Herrera's turned this over. Dodgy the old ball out to Matera. And eventually, Montero puts it into Landajo. We've got a box kick going on. Everything's happening here for Argentina. What a tackle there from, that was Lavanini. Now it's Lowe, throws the dummy. Montero does well. He keeps on. Combrink pulls him down and turns the ball over. Now it's the big left winger who's given it straight away. Habana, advantage to Argentina. Another forward pass, I think. That's the call in the tackle. Player going backwards. Wow, that wasn't forward. Crouch. Diego, the one taking the ball. And this game has really just gone up a gear in the last few minutes. Another scrum feed for Landajo and Argentina. Solid one this time by both sides, neither giving an inch. Issa, he'll run away with it. Landajo's in support, misses one out, gets it to Orlando on the bounce, and he does well with it. But support is not there at all. And South Africa come away with it. Strauss, nice ball away. Oh, Dialini is hammered. Oh, great covering there from Shapiro. The loose head prop getting everywhere on the field is Habana. Slips through the tackle of Tukulet, but not that of Issa. Yanties away, it goes, looking for a way through. Kosh gets it to Diego. Diego takes it just outside the 22. Offload's going well at the moment for South Africa. It's Faf de Klerk this time. It's hammered to ground on the 22. Loses the ball. Matera around the corner. Here's Cordero. Another opportunity. Santiago. Oh, he gets past. And Huskinen's left foot does. And away goes Santiago Cordero for a second. Well, that's the X factor this kid brings. He can carve the defense to absolute ribbons. Give it a chance. He smokes him. No chance here for the fullback. And he just leaves Usa for dust. And goes carting away another 50 meters. And dots down unopposed as Combrink comes across. The little step went to show and go, but the cover defense was dreadfully slow. And Tarawera, of all people, leading the chase. And he was never going to really be a serious chance of combating that of Santiago Cordero. So Sanchez back here again, right in front of the sticks, a place where he missed an absolute sitter of a penalty. Takes a shot now, and it's an easily shot one as well, right in front. 17-0, half-time goes as the kick was taken. So the two teams will make their way off now for the half-time break. It is 17-0, Argentina doing it quite easy, quite convincingly at the moment over South Africa. 17-0, that's the most important stat of the sheet, but possession has all been one-way traffic, 71% to 29%. It's hard to win a game with only 29% of the ball. South Africa is showing that already. Their defence has been well and truly tested, but Argentina and South Africa both making a number of errors, 7-4, and the line breaks as well, thick and fast, 5-2, Argentina well and truly in front. They should be as well, given the ball that they have had. But South Africa, you've got to say, they would be a lot happier coming into this halftime break, securing a couple of those chances that they threw away and spat out in the latter part of the first half. So a lot of work for them to do to come back into this matchup. They trail by 17, but we all know that is not enough to say you've won at halftime. So back to halfway we go. Out in Yantis is there. He's got the ball. Argentina, they are absolutely humming with this lead. It's a Springboks kickoff deep. They go down to Matera, who fires away quickly as Sanchez. Leguso on in support! And the open sider fires away Hernandez! And it's a touch. Well, an explosive start from Leguso. Support passes just didn't find the link. And now Strauss to throw the line out. Oh, stolen ball in the middle. Well played, Lavanini. Here's Hernandez again. He messed up the first one. Now he chips over to Musin. A race, a chance. Oh, the regather goes back to Sanchez. Almost doing it all himself. Move breaks down. Short side, there's room, there's Dumas, there's Montero. And there's the third try. Big strong finisher, didn't need an ounce of it. Trundled his way over, and yes, Creevy gives him the big thumbs up. He knows how important that score should be. Quick thinking, Landaho, he took out Faf de Klerk, his opposite number. And then it was all up to left winger Montero to finish the job. And he does exactly that. There's Combrink, couldn't cover alongside Faf. They took the first man. And another try for Argentina really puts this one in absolute doubt now for the Springboks to get anything out of this match. Target a win, come away with not even a losing bonus point is a bit of a concern for the Springboks. As Sanchez makes no mistake, way out on the left. It's 24-0 Argentina, doing it easy at the moment over South Africa. Well, it makes you wonder where the comeback comes from. South Africa struggled in the opening round. They're doing it again, but still they trail this one. Orlando, away to Cordero. Slices in field, does well, but doesn't quite get the ball. Argentina stack into the ruck, but they won't find it. Here comes South Africa. De Klerk away to Itzebi. Good pass. Finding Kocha goes to Diego. Again, they try and compete for the ball. Yantis goes away. It goes nicely. And they find room out wide. Now it's a big chance for Combrink. Looks to the skies. Up he goes. Big opportunity. Try, yes. Surely, yes. It's over for Combrink. And Ruam Combrink scores for the Springboks. That is what we were expecting for quite some time. It started quite far back. Mahoje did well to link that ball through the back line, and of all tactics, to go to the sky from Combrink. Up against Tuchelet. And up against Montero out there as well. Unable to be stopped. So there it is. Is the spark in the comeback for the Springboks. Yantis out on the right-hand side. He makes no mistake whatsoever. A glorious kick from the Springboks fly half and out to Yantis' hands. The extras, it's 24-7. Back to halfway now come Argentina. Now the pressure is on them not to bomb this like they did in the opening round. Sanchez looks left side. He goes rather high and he goes rather deep as well. Mapu, dangerous runner with Dialini on his shoulder as well. So there for South Africa. Oh, but they lose the ball! What a crucial time! Issa hits into contact quickly. And slow ball comes back. Hernandez didn't really want that. Found Creevy. Creevy! Bulldozing run from the captain. They look away for Lavanini. It's all forwards out here. Alimano! Alimano! He's got room! He's got Quintero! Quintero in for Orlando! Orlando can't find a way through. South Africa, though, they got numbers back and they do the job well. Hussein gets the kick away. And he clears trouble for the Springboks. Well, it looked like Argentina were looking to just set up camp in the 22. Didn't quite work exactly how they wanted, turning the ball over, but there's 15 minutes to go now. Nendajo, away to Sanchez, little chip over the top for Lavanini. Not really working again as Sanchez was wiped out there. Comes back for Itzabeth, goes to Maholza, he gets it nicely away to Itzabeth again. De Klerk, Maholza, once again, nice ball to Dialandi, but it's advantage Argentina. Another forward pass, this time Damon Dialandi. Whoa, that was probably Crouch. Just about debatable.
Bind.
68 minutes tick on.
Set.
The dream South Africa have of coming back into this game is quickly fading with each second, but the forward pack will not give up and they strike a big scrum. 10 to go. De Klerk. Wide, Combrink, inside ball, he finds Lowe. Sets it up here. South Africa. Diego goes away to... Oh, Issa steals it from the grasp of Yancey's. And now Hernandez, away for Cordero. Cordero himself. Oh, great tackle, Usen. He's taken it away from Argentina. Dialini goes away. This is a great run from Jose, but he's taken... into touch. Leguzamon chasing him to the ends of the earth, into the earth, just for that tackle. 75 minutes on the clock now. Lendajo goes away to Sanchez. Sanchez pops away, choppy, and he earns another three. What a time to do it! The lead is out to 20. And Sanchez just props himself up, looking to run a set play, and he chops that over. 77 minutes gone, 27-7. It is all dead and buried now for the Springboks. They will be defeated in Argentina as Landajo looks to have a bit of a run, the scrum half. Stall ball comes back for Alimano. Orlando feeds it wide. Cordero has been amazing. Cordero again chips over the top, rapes with De Klerk, but he doesn't beat him. It all breaks down. Oh, Hernandez has stolen it out the back door. Orlando to Herrera, and Herrera pulls it in. Full time has gone. Sanchez, big pass. Montero, Bumfa, get out of the way. Issa away. Oh, Leguzamon scores. One of the great tries. What a finish. Argentina put salt onto the wound with Leguizamon. Watch this distribution and a big bang there going on Combrink from Montero. And then the offload was just world class support play from Issa. There's the bang. And here we go. Houston comes in to help. Gantz isn't quite enough on the ball. As the offload goes away again from Issa to Leguizamon out in the wing. And he finishes the job for Argentina. Speaking of finishing the job, it will be Sanchez, 32-7. Who would have thought it would have been this one-sided? These fans, they dare to dream, they dream to believe. And that team has done the job in a big way here against South Africa. There's the final whistle. Argentina with the monumental and massive win over South Africa. 34-7, the final scoreline. Big players coming into action as that match wore on. The left wing side with Montero was just destructive as ever for that last half, but we have to credit the man on the right, Santiago Cordero. Could have scored a hat trick, but he was just so electric, so hard to stop, and created so much room to move, so many chances as well. In the end, it was 4-1. Leguizamon, he got the last. Montero as well. Cordero grabbing a pair. 4 tries altogether. 4 conversions from Sanchez and 2 drop goals. Very much Puma Rugby right there. 34 points. South Africa 7. Well, they come with a whole flurry of chances. A real opportunity to get back in the game. They butchered a lot in the first half. Ruan Combrink was the scorer. Yanti's got the conversion. But so many butchered chances from the South Africans. You could say they could have easily got themselves another 2 to 3 tries without really being too unreasonable about it. They had the opportunity, the chances were there. They just could not finish their dinner at all. Unfortunately, we don't get to see the line breaks in there, but handling errors is one that features quite heavily. 11-6, showing that if South Africa had had their A game on, they should have well and truly been back in this matchup. 68% of possession, that is dominance, that is one-sided as much as you'll get, and it's hard to win a game, like we said at halftime, with just 30% of the ball. When you're just chasing the ball around, defending, very tiring, and hard to really get your head and your team into the attacking frame. Territory even was all with Argentina, near on 60-40 on the percentages for the territory as well. But all in all, it was a dominant display from the Argentinians in front of their home crowd. What a game and what a rugby championship we have already this season. All 4 sides have shown that they're not complete pushovers, and at this stage you'd say Australia are probably favourites to be the wooden spooners because they haven't performed whatsoever, but their task possibly has been tougher against the All Blacks. Argentina and South Africa have both shown good and bad things about their game so far in this tournament, but at this stage it is the All Blacks who are well and truly out front as favourites from their opening 2 matches. Alright, that wraps up my time for today. Again, apologies for the dodgy old voice, still in recovery mode from these bloody flus and bugs going around, but hopefully we'll be back to 100% very, very soon. Plenty more action to come from this week as well. We'll be having a look at especially, not to mention other things, but especially the contract deals for Nathan Nicholls. So keep your eyes peeled for those coming up in the next couple of days. But for today, thank you for tuning and watching. Hope you've enjoyed, and I'll see you all next time. Until then, take care.